Hello, hello, everybody. Let me just turn that down a little bit. And that. Hello, hello, everybody. Sal here. I hope you're all doing fantastic. I am doing awesome. Oh, sorry. I just have to turn off the color correction. There you go. Looks more dark and dreary now, but you know. Yes. Today is a really, really, really awesome day. Today is the day we are going to play the last special episode, pre-order episode, of Life is Strange Before the Storm. And yeah, I am ready. My body isn't ready, but I am ready. I just hope I don't get too many disturbances. I think it's in extras. No? Should be around. Episodes? Ah, here we go. Bonus episode. Farewell. Whew. I'm not ready, but I'm ready. I'm ready to cry. Let me see the settings here. I can't remember. I have one save file. I don't think the save file has anything to do with it. Subtitles, normal size, yep. Semi-opaque. Can't remember what that means. So, no. There you go. Voices, sound effects. There you go. Game settings, no. Vibration, don't need that. Mouse sensitivity is good. Key bindings, I already remember. Game settings, already did that. Toolbot, I don't have that. How to play, I already know that. So, are we ready? I'm not 100% ready, but... let's do this. Ooh, I'm not ready. Okay.
Ready, I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing. I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
You know what the best part is? It's the same voice actors as the first game. That went well.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen! That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now. In a few days, my whole family have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Just do it? Please, don't make this worse than it has to be. Just tell her. Come on, you can do it. Just make this episode last like a few seconds. I'll live with it.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place. Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll.
Yep, that's Max.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel.
The Adventurous...
I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
The Adventurous Adventures of Supermax and Dr. Kloenstein. Crime fighting has really soared since we created these rocket boosters. Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Kloenstein? She disappeared. But what happened? We will never know.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course.
Well, Bongo ain't alive, is he?
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
That looks horrible.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. All right, back to the junk mines.
Ah, this is such a...
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
Well, I guess that's trash.
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bear.
Explore Oregon.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
A minus. B. This is kind of different from the first time we saw Chloe with B's and C's and also being like, or C's and F's and being out of school.
That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact. Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
I just remembered. No? How do I check my journal again? Oh, she doesn't have a journal! Wait, no? Treasure map, is that what I have to find? Okay.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
To the parents of Chloe Price, their parents, congratulations! Your child, Chloe Price, has been accepted for September 2008 admission to Blackwell Academy. We have offered places to approximately 100 students out of 1,200 applicants. Your child excelled in all criteria for admission. An open house for admitted students and parents will be held on March 26th, April 2nd. March 26th. April 2nd is the deadline to inform us of your intentions regarding admission. Your admission reply from form is included. For those who require financial aid, please contact Blackwell's Office of Financial Assistance. We look forward to welcoming you and Chloe to the Blackwell Academy family. Sincerely, Marco S. Gonzalez, Director of Admission. Awesome.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know. I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Ah, this is so sad.
People say a lot of things about Prescott.
By generation from the Prescott family, foundation.
This is pretty cool.
Well, let's trash just so we actually help.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age. Guess we'll have to play again soon and find out.
That's so Chloe.
I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore. Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
Yeah, right.
Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine.
It's fine.
It's filled with holes and falling apart.
That never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
Okay, then. I don't believe you, but okay. Let's see if we can trash this.
This seems like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowances cost?
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Okay, I guess I'm not gonna trash the shark either. I'm supposed to help here, not, you know.
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures.
I agree, Chloe. Let me talk.
I can't help you if you won't trash anything.
I'll trash some stuff.
How about an old toy that Chloe no longer plays with?
Okay. Thank you for the hint, Max. I'll just look around the room first.
Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies.
Nerd.
Whoa. Talk about embarrassing.
So I'm just gonna forget this even was here and not trash it. Boy band cards. Where she's drawn boobs on them. Yeah, I'm just gonna pretend like that doesn't happen. Nope, we'll not even touch that. I don't even want to. Okay, kind of want to figure out the. Okay, I want to figure out the. Out the context.
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Okay, then. You're not throwing away anything.
Whenever I'm ready. I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
Let me try this then, see what she says.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care if you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
True.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
So childish. Yeah, I can lie down. Time for screenshots.
It's so hard to believe. This room, this house, this town. All in the past now. Soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Damn it. I can't believe this is real myself. This is gonna be horrible. Well, let's talk and not argue.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but... at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Well, tell her now.
Actually, Chloe, I... really have to tell you something. It's... I... don't know how
holy
to...
shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is... it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever.
Ooh.
This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Let's listen.
Ready to find out?
audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia. Captain Bluebeard and Longback Silver.
You were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
What? Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it.
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame.
As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Dude, that was... amazing. I can't believe you still have that. I would never throw away something so precious.
So precious.
Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver. Oh my god. The Crow's Nest, the saloon, the cockpit, the galley, the cannons, and treasure keep. Ooh, it's in the front. Why is the anchor at the back and not at the front? Isn't that like... Damn it. The Bane of Arcadia, that's a good name. A ship name. Long Mac Silver, Captain Bluebeard. Well, yeah. Pogo the Pirate. The gang. Pirate rules. No bathing. No boys on the ship. No sharing pirate secrets. Always share plunder. Always bury treasure. Always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Captain's log. I need to do this. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. I just buried treasure. I come under attack again. The evil commander Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is, and wants to steal it from us. We are doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it, because our enemies want our treasure so bad. We must make sure the map is only readable to us, Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver. To plunder and riches, Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Yep, it is all the map.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. But where could it be?
Of course.
Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude.
Selfie.
Subject the first selfie. And photographer. You really do it all, Max.
See? Max did the selfie before it was cool. She is indeed a hipster.
ruins. Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Oh, this is a choose-your-own-adventure book. Max and Chloe's Sewer Adventure by Maxine Caulfield and Chloe Price. Read. You are Max and Chloe, the best friends and students in school. You sit in class until suddenly a cute squirrel arrives at the window. It is so cute. You want to pet it. Pet the squirrel, page 8. Don't pet the squirrel, page 3. Well, of course we're gonna... That's page 2. Page 8. Oh god. Go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course. Why wouldn't you? It's cute. It's a cute squirrel. And you want to pet it. Hey, Mrs. Squirrel, you say. Ah, stop biting me, you say next, because the squirrel is now biting your hand. But it's too late. You have rabies. Mrs. Anders has to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her very sad. Guess you shouldn't have pet the squirrel. The end. Fuck. It was page 3. Anders likes squirrels. They are so cute and nice. You must be very mean. The squirrel seems annoyed that you ignored her. She runs in and steals the book report right off your head, right off your desk, then runs back outside. The squirrel stole my book report, you tell the teacher. Whatever you say, Mrs. Anders responds, clearly not believing you. What do you do? Chase the squirrel. Stay in class. I'll chase the squirrel. Well, that's 4. As soon as Miss Anders turns around, you run out the window and chase the squirrel. That is a very bad thing to do. You hope you don't get in trouble later, but you probably will. Outside, you look around, but you can't find the squirrel. Is she gone? Oh, there she is. Standing next to a sewer hole. you run up to her, but she gets scared and jumps down. Oh boy. Do you really want to go down there? Jump down the sewers, find another way. I'll jump into the sewers, so back to page 2. Oh. You're very stupid, brave. You leap down into the sewers. Thankfully, there's a pile of trash. banana peels and dirty diapers to land on. Phew. You hear a squirrel sound in the distance. So you run to follow it. There are many twists and turns. Eventually, you come to a fork in the road. But now's not the time for eating. So you put the fork back down and consider the two paths in front of you. Wow. Didn't you already complete this stuff? No, this is the bonus episode. This was in an episode you got if you pre-ordered it. On the ground, I see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of chewed up paper to the right. Which way do you go? But I know. This is the bonus episode. Farewell. It came out today, so I'm finishing that. Let's go left since all the small footprints go that way. Though they don't look like, Page 9. Oh god. They picked right! I mean, left. Which was right. It's confusing. In the distance, you see the squirrel, but he's not moving. In fact, he's dead! Who would kill a poor squirrel? So, wasn't the squirrel a she? Oh. What? Okay, suddenly the ground begins to shake. Around the corner, a giant mat appears. It's the biggest rat. It's the biggest rat you've ever seen. The biggest anything you've ever seen. It is the Rat King. The Rat King is wearing a crown, standing on the throne of all your missing homework, including your book report. What do you do? Run towards it. Run away. I run towards it, of course. Oh, you're dead. Your dad always tells you to run towards your problems, not away from them. Unfortunately, you picked a really bad time to start listening to him. You run right towards the Rat King. At first, he seems surprised. You try to punch him in his face, but you forgot about his long, hairy, gross tail. He wamps you up like a boa constrictor and drops you into his mouth, swallowing you with one gulp. Now you get to see what the inside of a rat looks like. This would make a great science report. Too bad you won't believe, or you won't live to tell it, or be alive to tell anyone. The end. Okay. That was the other one. Run away. Page 5. You run away like a scaredy cat. I don't blame you. That thing is gross. As you run, you almost trip on a small shiny object. You pick it up. It's a lighter. Your mom never tells you to play with... Or never lets you play with these. But she's not here right now, is she? Now is your chance to kill the Rat King and protect all the students' homework once and for all. Is your chance to be a hero. Do you do it? Just kidding. You don't get a choice. You may get to choose some things, but I'm still the offer here. You have to attack the Rat King. But how do you want to attack him? Burn his tail or burn his throne? 11. I want to burn his tail. Oh god. I'm dead. You decide to burn his gross, long, hairy tail. Good plan. Whoosh, the Rat King's tail is on fire. Is it not like that one bit? He starts freaking out, waving his tail around like crazy. You know all the trash and dirty diapers in the sewers? Those are highly flammable. Which means that some are the same as flammable. For some reason. Yes. Highly inflammable. What? No. Highly inflammable means they don't burn. Suddenly. Highly inflammable. What? And that means, okay. The entire sewer catches on fire. You're surrounded by gross sewer flames. Is that really how you die? Burning to death with the Rat King in a disgusting sewer? Yes, it is. The end. Okay. What was the other one? 13. Okay. 13. You decide to burn the king's throne. It hurts you to burn all of that amazing homework, including your wonderful book report. But you remember that it is for a good reason. Soon as the throne catches on fire, the Rat King begins screaming, "No, my throne!" Suddenly, the Rat King begins to shrink. Before long, he's back to the size of a normal rat. Can't even climb out of his huge crown. Aw, he's so cute now. You run back to the class and tell Mrs. Anders all about the Rat King and everything that happened. Not only does she forgive you for not having your book report, but she declares that you are the greatest hero in the school. The end. Until the next Max and Chloe adventure. This is so inventive, Maxine and Chloe. But next time, please do the book report you were assigned. Ah, beautiful. Of course. So they did this for their teacher. Of course.
Oh, yes! Take that, Rat King.
Took me like a few tries, but I did it. Okay.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year.
Chloe Price, teacher Miss Shelley, date. 100%. Great job as always, Chloe. Now please, try to pay attention in class instead of drawing pictures with Maxine. Social Studies. Stars and Stripes, Chapter 11. The Civil War began when southern states wanted to secede from the Union. President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln, gave the Gettysburg Address and issued the Emancipation Proclamation. The people who fought... The people who fought in slavery were called abolitionists. Harriet Tubman worked with the Underground Railroad to help slaves escape to freedom. In 1864, Congress passed the 13th Amendment a change or addition to the constitution ending slavery. That was like a school thing. Social studies. Is that really social studies? Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I've already looked for this.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together. Not sure I learned much about the stars and stripes.
Release me. Hey, I found it, Chloe.
Bingo.
Chloe's secret lair, that's her bedroom, I think. Dark cavern. Treasure Island, I know where that is. And Prize Castle. Hmm. That's her room, of course, I think. Or did she have a tree hut? No, she didn't. Huh. The amulet is in the dark cavern.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we?
Oh, collection. Oh, Chloe's lair. I've got all the collection thingies. Awesome.
We make some crazy puzzle. You need the telescope and the amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh. Why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Was? Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Oh, you're sending me up, but not yourself.
And once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver ride again, bitches!
The bitches?
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Hell yeah.
Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago, but Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
I didn't even notice that in the game.
I don't think I've ever actually seen anyone reading these books.
So Max has been snooping around the house for years.
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
Narnia.
I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation.
Tollbridge, an Oliver Sharp mystery. You'll pay with your life. Still working there,
eh? Two Whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close.
Oh, so she likes Belgian waffles. I don't believe that.
It's so sweet that Chloe's mom takes this photo with her to work. Chloe's parents are so cute.
And William and Chloe. Gum.
Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking.
Nicotine gum. That always works.
Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe Phoenix. It's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so cool.
Portland to Phoenix.
Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it.
Grand Canyon, awesome. The other one he says is William. Is that? I wonder if it's Max also, if Max is going to get in there and there. His bike and jeep tour is available daily. 277 miles of beauty. Yes.
Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time?
William Price, Bay Bowlers, 2002. Most strikes. And a pamphlet.
It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it.
Really? Ah. The College of Arcadia's Early Childhood Education Certification Program. Take the first step. Be the first step. Early childhood education is the first step toward toward lifelong learning. Night classes available. If this is what you want, we'll find a way to make it work. Lab William. Ah. Awesome. Too adorable. Let's look at the computer.
Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about.
Nolan Price, Joyce. Meeting this week. Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Price. I would like to begin by saying we are thrilled to have Chloe at Blackwell. Rest assured, her scholarship is not in jeopardy at this time. However, it seems that she's having trouble transitioning into this new, more challenging environment. I'm emailing to set up a time to talk about the incident that occurred last week. I'm very concerned about Chloe's behavior and would like to work with you to take steps to correct it as soon as possible. I'm sure you are dedicated to Chloe's success. Here as we are. The future needs excellence. Guards Raywells.
Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her.
Ray, Chloe was not the only student to act out that day. And if you ask me, Marissa Rogers isn't the victim. She's the bully. Maybe if both sides of the story were heard before placing blame, your school would be less... challenging environment, or be a less challenging environment, or your students. Focus on your school. I'll focus on my daughter. Ooh, William Price.
A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there.
Right here. Price, voicemail. Voice of voice. These types of people are exactly why I didn't come when Chloe had a black hole. I'll figure this out. I promise. I love you too. To Joyce from William. From Joyce. To William, probably. Why doesn't it say? They use Gmail, apparently. Okay, I think it's time. Like, it is the time stamp for that. I forgot to tell you, Mrs. Rogers called while we were out yesterday. I left a message. I'm still on the answering machine. It's still on the answering machine. Please be careful when you listen to it. I don't want Chloe to overhear. We need to figure out how to handle this. I know the principal said her scholarship isn't in danger, but I still worry. Love you.
Sometimes I really wish I had siblings.
Aaron Price. I didn't know she had a brother. Oh no, that's the uncle. William Price. Subject. Thanks for the pressure washer. Hey Aaron, finally used your pressure washer today and I just wanted to say thanks again for letting me borrow it. Works like a charm. It's not our dream house, but now it can at least be the right color. If you want to come over next weekend and give me a hand, there'll be a cold beer in it for you. Give me a call. Hope everything is still going well. And tell Linda I say hello, William. Awesome. I think I'll need that in the future. You can always look for this damn window.
I'll ever take this view in again.
Oh yeah, I know you will. Hashtag spoilers, you will.
I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer. It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. The entrance to the dark cavern is in there. Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet.
I wonder what's in this room.
Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it.
I never do.
I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years.
If you can go downstairs.
I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back.
Okay, let's do this. The scary attic.
There it is. The dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door.
How the hell did they get up there the first time then?
I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
That one doesn't look healthy. Okay, then. Since you're asking for it.
Maybe this will make me tall enough to reach.
It won't, as far as I remember. Or I remember, as far as I know, this game is definitely going to make it crack in the bottom. Max is going to be sad. Oh no, never mind. Still can't reach
it. It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
I know. That's what I said. I knew we'd need that thing. I knew it, because I had played this game before. And this looked more, you know, better quality than this. I just say I love her t-shirt.
Almost there. Or
jank. Yeah, I guess it's a t-shirt.
Few more inches.
A few more inches, so you can't check it. Okay. Toolbox. No. Scale? No.
Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last game we ever plan here.
Okay, you needed a few more inches. Where do you want them inches from?
Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough.
Okay. What?
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
Okay.
I just need a few more inches to reach the attic.
Why don't you just take the chair and... I'm stumped. Get into the attic. Nope, from Chloe. And Max. Yeah, I got off of that. Okay.
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
Chloe, or Max, tell me, what do I need to get you to stand on? Oh god, I'm stuck. Something in Chloe's room, maybe? No?
Maybe I could stand on some books.
Some books, yes. Oh! Idiot, Salp. I'm an idiot. This is so going to fall apart.
That should be tall enough.
Oh, this is not going to go well. Oh yeah, mm-hmm. He's gonna pull it down and it's gonna fall. Oh no. I love the fact that they changed all of the pictures here. It used to be like a raven. Ugh, spider. Spider!
Awesome.
It's a light switch. There's a crib. Definitely not scary. Mm-hmm.
Man, there is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through. No Sharpie boob jobs. Disappointing.
Disappointing.
Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from. I can't get through with this chair here. I think I can squeeze through now.
Oh, and we have t-shirts. Or blankets. They look highlighted. Nope, they're just there. Wow.
Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom.
Oh god, look at the... It looks like there's been a hand on the top who's moved away the dust. This is definitely scary. Fish tank with algae.
I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack.
She's lost so many. I have to look at that.
It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult.
Big and burly. Yeah, right.
I need to move that desk, but this dresser is in the way.
Big and burly.
That's full
okay.
of decorations.
Chloe okay, Max. Sure.
Five. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. One step closer. Ugh, this desk's pretty heavy. This looks like it used to be a nice desk. I guess everything ends up in an attic eventually.
Old time cola. Yeah, this is like Coca-Cola cooler.
I never realized how much I liked vintage things. This cooler is awesome. Glad this thing is empty.
I'm expecting something horrible to happen.
Yes.
Just because this is Life is Strange. I'm expecting a hole to open up in the floor and Max falling down. That's really awesome. They actually made one of them.
This is a nice close-up shot. fitting reward for a journey full of
treasures. Oh, it's bottoms from a flask. This flask bottoms.
Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Gardening tool.
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
That.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
The last emates.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend. That's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. You find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way.
Didn't she have a... I remember in the trailer she had a hat on, like a pirate clothes. I might have actually been able to find that and wear it.
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank.
Yes.
It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go.
There's not much old color left to go, but okay.
One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off. This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something.
Oh no, Bongo.
Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard.
R.I.P. Bongo.
I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew. I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar.
I would have thought, like, what is she doing?
Comforting.
I need that amulet. What is she doing? She's playing with a ball.
These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going
to... Sup, dude?
Sup, dude?
Bro.
Bro?
Don't you mean sis?
Dweeb. She said that often.
Actually, I meant dweeb.
Dork.
Punk.
Punk. Punks are cool. You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You know it's gonna be weird when she says it.
That's all. Aww.
Talk about mushy. Where'd that come from?
I was just thinking about how awesome this day is. And how awesome we are. Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying.
I'm not crying, it's fine.
I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks. I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues. Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Toy soldiers as well.
Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it how I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Great art is never appreciated.
Yeah.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me. Do you drink this? Yar.
Yar.
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
Of course we're taking a photo. We are
hey,
a creep after all.
Chloe. Yar. Land ho.
Perfect.
She isn't shaking as vigorously as she did before. It's a goddamn cannon.
This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning, I can.
Yes, that's a good way to remove them.
Oh. I wish I could freeze this moment. I never have to leave it. Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas. I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead?
Dead men tell no tales. Oh, kite.
Are you ever going to get your
hot
kite
hot
down?
Dog.
It was unhappy in captivity. I set it free.
Hot dog, man.
You must be a hero to kites everywhere.
Have I looked at everything? Okay, I've looked at everything. Have I? Rum, toy soldiers. Yeah, I've looked at everything. There you go.
Wait just a minute. Yar! You must ask permission before setting foot or peg on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes. Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure. If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Chloe, you could never be a loser. Even if you tried.
Well, yeah. The best friend code requires you say that. It's just... this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
Oh, this is so sad and fun at the same time, you know?
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
I have a feeling we'll be having to use this shovel and that small shovel over there at one point in time.
Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag. Just like old times. Huh, Max? Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
I love this. Oh, this is gonna make me cry at the end, isn't it?
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Just she can't remember how it works, but I came.
Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with... something?
Here goes nothing.
It's upside down.
Okay. This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Okay. Huh?
Got it.
Oh, there you go.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right.
That's...
No, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
Your other right.
Your other right.
Sure thing. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me.
Really, this is gonna make somebody cry. Just wait for Chloe. Oh no, don't say that.
Bingo.
Yep. I'm looking forward to that too. I'm looking forward to the terrace. I love the animations in this version. I hope the next one is gonna be like this. Ooh, they hit something.
That is not what we buried.
Oh?
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
No, it's a time capsule.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
That looks so awesome. Of course. You've just been outside and then you step on the table.
Ahoy
of course.
There. Plankwalkers? It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
My now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you were so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
She doesn't like that, apparently. Let me read here. Dear Chloe, how are you today? I'm doing very well. It is Friday, June the 27th, 2003. It is summer vacation. We are making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We are making it pirate-themed. Wasn't it hilarious to find? These are some things we like. Favorite animal. Arabian horse. That's Max. Otter is Chloe. Favorite food. Lobster roll. Max. Coffee ice cream. Ooh, Chloe. Sounds good. Favorite class in school. Art or library. Max. And Chloe, science. Best friend, each other. That's both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies, etc.? That's all for now. Hope you're having a lot of fun being teenagers with your best friend. Sincerely, Maxine Caulfield. Too cute.
How about mine? What did I write?
Just Max.
This is so Chloe.
Hello from 2003. Here's a record of how we spent our days. Can you guess which one is real? We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. We have sleepovers at least once a week. Yep. We like extremely salty pretzels. I don't think so. Maybe? Or is it? We're in a race. We are in a race to see who can convince your parents to get the pet first. I think Chloe won that one, so yeah. We're going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. We have battled many foes and never failed to save each other. What did you guess? If you guessed all of them, you're right. Your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price. Yep.
You were really sweet.
Oh man, I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop.
A goop.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now. Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
Okay. I don't remember scratch
all
art.
These memories. I want to look at everything. This container looks like it could last 100 years.
Ooh, this is the last comic.
It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Maybe you should come down and power off flight. This dude's face off with me. So that was the last one. Power flight is dude's face off. There we go. Invention plans.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
Chopper. World's most comfortable seat. Switches pedals from wheels to blades. Ah, so you do the... Oh, cool. Also spins blades. Steel and flint. Flint and steel. Flaming fingers. Ray of sunshine. Sunlight enters here. Mirrors and lenses to strengthen sunlight. Laser beam shoots out here. Syrup. What? Oh, opens. Sorry, I'm an idiot. Opens intake window. I'm bad at reading. Awesome.
A time addictions. Capsule was such a good idea.
I know, right?
Oh, sorry.
Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
Oh, we see who wrote this. This is definitely Chloe. And this is Max. Predictions of the Future by Chloe and Maxine. We still hang out with each other more than with any other person. That's true. Both of us are medium popular. Maybe not. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. No. We do not make decisions without consulting each other. Taking skull off our enemies. What? Oh, other... what? More than... The talking skull of our enemies. Okay. Slash. We do not make decisions without consulting each other or slash the talking skulls of our enemies. Okay. Both of us have a pet. Nope. And Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could have come if she wanted. One of us has a little sister or brother. Nope. We are all doing well in school. Yes.
It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. Is writing once a week too often? Will I run out of things to say?
Yeah, you could see. Oh no! That's Chloe. And that's Max. I don't know.
Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
Yep.
It's good to see you, old friend.
Time to look around the house.
Looking at my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me.
She reads manga as well.
We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
Some dishes.
This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after a shift at the diner.
Let's tidy up. Yes, I know. Booyah.
Much better.
Shut up. I know.
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Good luck, hubby. We're so proud of your promotion. You get a week of Two Whales waffles in your own house. Your lovely, loving wifey. Wifey. Wow.
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
Oh, God. That's that picture. That's the picture that they took that day when... William died. No, that's not it. It can't be, because he's still alive. Where is he?
Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess, compared to that, Seattle's not so far.
Still the old pictures. Awesome. I will not listen to that tape.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
Oh god, what do I do? Do I listen to it? I'll come back to that.
Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance.
Allowance? Save 60%, spend 40%. Same here. Gift from Grandma, $18, spend 12%. Save it, 18%. There we go. Allowance. Save $6, spend 4%. Dad's painting assistant. Or save for though, spend. Damn. You're so responsible.
Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
An MMO? Oh my god. Wine stain, of course.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
So about women changing careers in midlife. Okay.
You sure were troublesome to find.
Please don't say the fucking... Okay, no. It isn't there. I was about to say, if the butterfly's there, I'm gonna go insane.
There. Now you've got something pretty to look at. Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things.
Mm-hmm. Halloween 2002. Those looks awesome.
I guess I should try talking to Chloe again about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything. This used to be the Rainy Day pirate ship. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Yes. Nope. I'm just taking some pictures here. It's fine.
I wish this moment could last forever.
It probably can. If I just leave it here so I don't have to finish, it lasts forever. You should really add a photo mode to this game. Okay, let me listen to the voicemail before I talk to her. I don't wanna, but...
I bet there's some really cute photos in there.
Okay, let's look at this.
I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
I can. There's a cap. There's a couch. I can. Okay.
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that? Okay, tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
There we got all the pictures. Talk to Chloe, okay. Let me first just listen to the thing. I think I've gotten everything around here. I got everything here. Yep. Got everything, I think, in there. I don't know. Yep. And here. I'm still working on it. Okay, let's do it. Leroy Jenkins and all that. Well, first you gotta check. Yep, I knew it. Umbrella.
These used to make great pirate swords. Goodbye, Vase. Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking you over anymore.
Oh. That's happened before? fucking Leroy Jenkins.
Hey, hold on.
Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
They both sound awful. Marissa and her mom.
They are. All Marissa talks about is, like, how much she hates her tutor, but she never does any homework.
I told you, I hate fake people. Is everybody there like that?
No, not everyone. But more than I'm used to. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe.
Oh, God.
What do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Is that... why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
That really sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Thanks, Max.
Can I rewind? No. Okay. I want to kill myself after that one.
Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
Another photo. Was it Chloe? Photograph Chloe alone. Chloe alone.
I can see what you're doing.
Just don't move. The artist at work.
Or trying to work.
True. Okay, let's...
I'm a little bit hungry. How about you?
I'm okay.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yep.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
Chloe always makes me look so much cooler than I really am.
That looks awesome.
The artist at work.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance.
Yes, tell her now. You've kind of, you know, wasted time here.
We might not be alone again once our parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
Tell her.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
Oh my god, get done with it. They're probably going to send William in a few. That's going to just make it even worse.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Why did you pretend like you didn't know?
I don't know. I guess I didn't want it to be true. We were both doing it, weren't we? All that pirate stuff, doing the treasure hunt. Wasn't that fun?
Of course, but...
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch. Okay, and visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Oh no. Liar.
Mom?
Black flies on the window sill. We are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill. And the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope here needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place. No man is an island. can't you see? Oh, well, maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone. Black flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are the whole. Comfort came against my will. Every story must grow old. Still I'd be a traveler, a gypsy's reins to face. But the road is wearier with that fool found in your place. No man is an island, or this I know. Can't you see, oh, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone? So here we are.
To be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. Dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.
Goodbye. Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, fuck me. Oh, I was expecting that, but oh my god. Go away, yeah. I'm not crying. I'm not either. Fuck my life. That hurts even more now. Oh no! I blame yourself. I blame me too. I'm sorry. Here you at least see what you're missing out on when it comes to Life is Strange. And I'm missing out. I don't like crying. It makes my head explode. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, at least now you know that you shouldn't. I'm sorry, I didn't know. Should have warned you. Oh my god. Actually, Birch wrote this too. Oh my god, she wrote all of it. Well, not all of it, not the first part, but yeah. Jesus Christ. Maxine Goldfield, Chloe Price, and William Price. All of the original voice actors, which is awesome. I don't cry often, and when I do, it's not for long, but oh my god. This is gonna fuck me over for a while. It's so funny that so many people have worked on it. Don't know if I can RP, but yeah, I had a headache before this, so. Aw, I really hope you can. Love to, you know, roleplay. I'm sorry. I should have warned you. I didn't know. I don't know. Do you have any, like, paracetamol or something like that, maybe, to help? I'm definitely going to put this on YouTube. I did it with the other ones. I didn't do the third episode because I'm an idiot. Like I said, I was feeling shit before. I've been all day. And Panda's playing this as well. Yeah, she definitely is. She's playing this right now. I just know it. She's probably going to be close to the end as well. Oh, fuck me. I'm probably going to end the stream for a little bit. Brian Finkelstein is the hot dog man. Nah, she started way later than you. Ah, okay. But yeah, no. I think I'm gonna end stream when this is done. And then take a few to just compose myself. I guess I need that right now. Ay, ay, ay. It's surprising that, you know, a 1 hour, 1.5 hour, or almost two hour game has so many people working at it. Unless they, you know, just mention every single person who works as Square Enix, because that's a lot. And Deck 9 at that. There's a garden bit. Oh god, she's gonna be at the end soon. Oh lord. I think this is gonna kill Panda. Definitely will. My god. So long. There we go. Original farewell score composed and performed by Mike Regan. Ben and Summer and Glenn Hayter. Feel for music. License tracks. Black Flies as the ending track. There we go. This game was developed in the state of Colorado. Well, thank you, Colorado. Special thanks to the team. It's funny that a lot of people have like the name Max Ean or Max. Yeah. So many names that are so similar to Maxine. Thanks for playing. There is so an ending part, I just know it. There has to be... No? 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 Okay. Can't see the choices. My god, this game. Thank you so very much for joining me today, everybody. It has been a pleasure streaming for you guys today. I will see you guys in the next stream in a few, you know, few minutes maybe. Once I compose myself and Jesus, get ready. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Thank you so much for joining. Goodbye for now.